Hello friends, this video is my attempt to contribute to the Mega Fave Numbers project by James Grime, an enthusiastic mathematics educator, expositor and explorer par excellence. Here is his channel, which you can find on YouTube and which you should consider subscribing whether you are curious about maths or not. Because even if you aren't, he is sure to make you switch to being curious very soon. I can assure you of that. I have put the link to his channel in the description. So what is this Mega Fave Numbers project? It is just a call to come up with any interesting number greater than 1 million and make a video about it. So my submission to this project is the number 1 million. I do not claim that this is my favorite number. However, it is connected to a very interesting scientific as well as philosophical fact. The interesting part is this. If the matter in the universe were uniformly distributed, a cube of side 1 million kilometers would weigh very close to 100 grams. I repeat, if the matter in the universe were uniformly distributed, a cube of length, breadth, height 1 million kilometers would weigh very close to 100 grams. This number captures the vastness and the emptiness of the universe. It is this vastness and emptiness that we meaning Douglas Duhaime from Yale University and I, that we have attempted to capture in this simulation that you can see on your screen. In this simulation, which you can access by going to this link, which I will also put in the description. In this simulation, we are looking at Milky Way at the center from a distance of 200 megaparsecs, which is 650 million light years. Now each of these dots that you can see here are individual galaxies, are complete individual galaxies. And Milky Way, as I have already said, is at the center. The plane of the Milky Way, as you know, is a disk, and the plane is from top to bottom. Now, it is not that there are no galaxies over here. However, those galaxies are obscured by the arms of the Milky Way. So, we cannot see them. Therefore, we can see only in this region. And therefore, we have observed these galaxies. We can travel in and out using the mouse scroll wheel like this. So here you can see the distance is reducing as we travel closer and closer to the Milky Way. So here you can see the Milky Way colored in magenta. And these are all the galaxies around it. Even though we seem to be surrounded by matter, we are in an exceptional matter-rich pocket of the universe known as the Milky Way. Here we can see the Milky Way in magenta. The size of each of the dots is about 32 kiloparsecs or about 100,000 light years, which is also the diameter of the Milky Way. Many of you may have heard that the nearest galaxy to us is the Andromeda galaxy. So let us try to find the Andromeda galaxy over here. Andromeda galaxy is also known as M31. So we can see that the M31 galaxy is centered and colored yellow. So we can travel to it using the mouse scroll. And we see that the Andromeda is here. This is the Andromeda colored yellow. And here is the Milky Way colored magenta. So as you can notice, the Andromeda doesn't seem to be the closest galaxy to the Milky Way. There are many closer galaxies here. So all these are dwarf galaxies. There are many dwarf galaxies around Milky Way. In this simulation, we have only shown the prominent ones, which are the Small Magellanic Cloud, the Large Magellanic Cloud, the UMI Dwarf, the Draco Dwarf, and others. However, let me show you. Yeah. So this is the LMC, the Large Magellanic Cloud, the Small Magellanic Cloud, and there are other dwarf galaxies here. So you would be amazed to know that there are about 60 satellite galaxies of Milky Way. About 60 dwarf galaxies around Milky Way before the Andromeda Galaxy. So here is this list in the Wikipedia. So when we explore this simulation, we can clearly see that there are vast empty pockets of space around tiny galaxies, you know, tiny in comparison to the emptiness around those galaxies. So if we take a step back and center again on the Milky Way, we can see that the nature of distribution of matter is filamentary. You may have heard about this fact elsewhere, but here we can also see and explore it. For example, here is, you know, one such filament through which you can see the Milky Way. So here is the Milky Way in the center, and as we go back, we get many galaxies in this filament. However, in some other direction, we can go back and we do not get any galaxy. So we see that there are large pockets of emptiness, also sometimes called as voids in the astronomy and astrophysics parlance. And there is distribution of matter in some pockets. So for example, as we have seen here, this is expected because due to the nature of the gravity, there would be this distribution of matter, a lumpy distribution of matter, and the rest of the space would become empty. So this is my submission to this project, simply because it is also connected to another very interesting fact. This density of the universe that I have told, that in a cube of side 1 million kilometers by 1 million kilometers by 1 million kilometers, it would weigh 100 grams. This density of the universe is the critical density. As far as we know, this seems to be the density at which the universe would neither rip itself apart in a big rip nor recontract. In other words, if the density were greater than this, even slightly greater, the universe would eventually collapse back onto itself because gravity would eventually dominate. And if the density were lesser than this, then the universe would continue expanding forever and would rip itself apart eventually in a big rip. However, surprisingly, it seems that the universe is very close to this critical density, and it almost is exactly equal to the critical density. How do we know that? Because when we observe the cosmic microwave background radiation, which is spread uniformly in the entire universe, we see that the uniformity of it is such that it can only emanate from a flat universe. So, our universe can only be flat if it is exactly equal to this critical density. A detailed discussion of these concepts would be not appropriate for this video. However, if you are interested, you can explore the PBS Spacetime channel on YouTube, which you can find here. It is an excellent channel which will explain all these concepts. Thank you. I hope you found the number interesting and somewhat reflective of the nature of the reality in which we live. And I hope that it gives you some food for thought and some food for reflection. Thank you.